2 meters.
2 meters, right. We're going to have to get the mic as close as possible.
Yeah, I hate to do it, but that's what you got to do.
I think we should do a lockdown, like a more strict, stricter lockdown.
Oh, really? How so? Like, what would you suggest to, what would be better?
I think unless you're going out for essentials, you shouldn't be going out. And I think they should enforce stricter mask laws.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
If they were forcing everybody to be vaccinated, you'd be okay with that?
I'd be totally okay with that.
I wouldn't consider it a violation, again, because of the idea that, you know, you, if you're being vaccinated, you're saving me as well as yourself. So I don't, at some point, you have to make a balance between personal liberties and the general good. And I think general good should outweigh people's sort of reluctance.
I've had COVID. Okay. So catch COVID, then you'll, I don't care, just shut the damn thing down. Get the people off the street if they have to.
This is planned out event. We're going to, like, this didn't happen by accident. There's a plan in place and you don't have a choice. You're part of a plan. So yeah, there's worse is yet to come.
I couldn't care less about a lockdown. I'm going to do what I want to do. You can come to my house if you want, but you know, arrest me, but that's it. Yes.
Freedom's important.
It is.
I'm not anti-mask. No. I'm not. I'm pro-choice. You know, I want people to be able to choose to be able to wear a mask or not. I don't want anybody to have to force a mask on me. That's a violation of my rights.
I have a health problem. That's kind of fucking stupid.
What's that?
I have a health problem. So coming from a person who has a health condition, that's really fucking stupid.
I don't view it as violating my rights at all. I think they're violating my rights by not wearing a mask when I'm around. I think that my safety should come first for them, and they're being selfish by not wearing masks.
You know, the virus is a lot smaller than the holes in the mask. The holes in the mask are a certain size, and the virus is a lot smaller than that. So, you're done. Hey there, guys. This is Dan Dixon reporting for Press for Truth.
And William at Got Dialogue.
We're here in downtown Vancouver today because we're going to ask some people how they feel about these strict lockdown measures like mandatory masks and the potential for a coming curfew.
And how far they're willing to take this and where they want to draw the line.
Let's see what they say. We're just curious today to get people's thoughts on the current pandemic and specifically the government's response to it.
Well, I think that considering the situation and the sort of the time space they had to get things together, and they've done a pretty good job of it.
For me, I think personally, I think that they're doing the most that they can, and I think everyone should be able to participate and do their part in this pandemic, and like be able to keep everybody safe.
It's definitely could be better. I think like inter-province traveling is still like so huge. So for sure, like especially I come from a small town, but it's a traveled spot where people come to, and I can tell like there's so many people from different countries and like other provinces all there. So
you're saying it should be open more for people to be able to travel, or shut down more?
I don't know. It's so tough. I want it to be open just because like I think everyone's kind of over it, but. It's also like, oh, it should be, I don't know. I really don't know, but yeah, it's confusing.
I think compared to other places, it's a little bit better, but I don't think they're handling it as much as they should, considering that there were government officials, I think in Vancouver, that were exposed to traveling to America while trying to enforce other people to like conform to the rules. I think that's a little hypocritical.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
What do you think about travel within Canada? Should it be open from province to province?
No, I don't think so.
No, why not?
BC's rate is getting higher every day. I think we should do a lockdown, like a more strict, stricter lockdown.
Oh, really? How so? Like, what would you suggest to, what would be better?
I think unless you're going out for essentials, you shouldn't be going out. And I think they should enforce stricter mask laws.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So right now it's mandatory to have masks indoors. You think there should be more than that?
Yeah.
We always wear our mask. Lots of Vancouver people wear their masks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think about ever since it became mandatory to wear them indoors? What are your thoughts on that mandate?
Well, we do, and it's because we know that there is a risk if you don't. And so people should say, yep, I gotta wear something that will keep me away from that virus.
Now, humor me, I like in a restaurant, for me, it seems silly to have a rule that you have to wear it to go to the table, but then you can take it off. I often use the analogy, that's like having a peeing section in a pool. It doesn't really work, right?
Well, yeah, I understand the issue, and the point is that I guess you can't eat with a mask on.
Right.
So if you're going to be indoors and eating, you have to take off your mask.
Why make them wear it to go to the table?
To lessen the spread of the particles. That still makes sense to me.
Right.
Right. It's carried by particles in the air, and the less exposure you have to letting your particles loose, the better it is, and it's a compromise.
Right. Aren't the holes in the mask a lot larger than the virus, though? So it could.
It's not 100% protection, but it's actually protecting other people. Not protecting you. You're trapping the particles that so they're not going into the air.
Catch COVID, and then you'll understand.
Which ones, though?
I've had COVID. Okay. So catch COVID, then you'll understand. I don't care. Just shut the damn thing down. Get the people off the street if they have.
Oh, you had COVID?
I've had COVID. I'm coming out. My wife's still in the bloody hospital. Okay. So this is not a fucking joke.
Wow. And when did you get COVID?
On the 19th, I was tested positive.
Of December.
Oh. I spent a beautiful Christmas
in a hospital. And what were your symptoms, sir?
They started off with a cough.
Okay.
And right now, I'm having a hard time walking.
Yeah.
Okay, and this is over a month ago, and it's like I'm exhausted. I'll have to stop and take a break on my walk, and I'm constantly trying to breathe.
Would you be wearing a mask had you not gotten COVID-19? Like in public, I mean? Like, would you be wearing a mask?
I think COVID-19 is just the start of what they have planned out.
Okay.
What the real plan is how the economy will collapse, and then you're going to be get your food stamps, and then when you're hungry and you have nowhere to live, you don't have a choice, and then they go make this a real world that you don't even know how you go survive.
They said that masks didn't work. Now they work. I don't believe it. What I'm more upset about is the lockdown, mostly. Kids are back at school, but I can't go over to my friend's house.
Yeah.
You know, that's the only lockdown. No, thank you.
Yeah. Some people are starting to see it as a bit of a violation of their charter rights.
I don't view it as violating my rights at all. I think they're violating my rights by not wearing a mask when I'm around. I think that my safety should come first for them, and they're being selfish by not wearing masks.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're lucky that people are being told to wear their masks, mm-hmm. and it certainly is helpful to us.
Right. Yeah. Have you heard of the exemptions that there are some people who have medical conditions, post-traumatic stress disorder, various reasons why they can't wear a mask? Have you heard of those cases?
I have heard. There's quite a few illnesses that people are using to say why they shouldn't wear the mask.
Right. So it's probably best to not assume why somebody's not wearing one, right?
Yeah. Just get a letter from your doctor and then
I'm pretty militant about masks. When I see somebody in there with their thing below their nose, I say, that's not a mask anymore unless you get it over covering your nose.
Right. They're also now actually testing the idea of maybe doing a curfew in Quebec. You can't leave your home past 9:00. What are your thoughts on those kind of measures?
Well, with the situation they have over there, that's probably the way to go.
Yeah.
I don't think we need that here quite yet. Hopefully not ever. But.
If it came here, would you be okay with that, or would you feel it's a little bit of a overstretch of your rights?
Personally, I would probably respect it.
They're talking about the idea of having a curfew where you can't leave home now after 9 p.m. What would you think if that came to Vancouver? Would that be good or bad?
I think there would be some people who wouldn't like that, but I wouldn't have a problem with it.
With the measures set in place, I think it's nothing out of the extraordinary. Like, I think it's just a little, like, extra step of precaution. And, like, it's nothing that I think is super life-threatening. Like, I will do my part, and it's nothing that affects me.
I mean, everything is extraordinary about what's happening, so I'm not sure what you mean by that when you say it's not out of the ordinary.
It's nothing that we've ever experienced before, but I don't think it's something that, like, people can take, like, lightheartedly about, like, let's say not wearing masks, not following social distancing procedures, but, it's not something that, like, should affect society way too much. Because, like, it's something that we all do to keep everybody safe.
We're now into 2 weeks to flatten the curve was almost a year ago now. How far are we going to let this go?
Well, I'm just waiting for my vaccine shot.
Okay, right.
Yeah. Just we couldn't get our vaccine shot.
That's the one issue I have with our government. I think the rollout of the actual shots is slower than I would have liked. I think they could expedite the getting it into people's arms. That's the one part if I had to criticize that part.
If they were forcing everybody to be vaccinated, you'd be okay with that?
I'd be totally okay with that. Just as long as it keeps everybody safe. Like, of course, I think that it should be, like, the test trial should be pushed a little further. But if it's something that will benefit us now, then I don't see a problem with it.
What about the people that don't want to be vaccinated? Like, and the government, you know, breaking down their door and forcing them into camps to get vaccinated.
Happen.
Yeah. What about that?
When it comes to, like, breaking down people's doors, I think it's all about education and, like, educating people who don't really have the knowledge of, like, how it could benefit everybody, especially themselves, keeping them safe. As long as, like, it's about educating everybody.
Yeah, but after you educate them, they still refuse, and then you have to force them to do whatever it is you want them to do, right?
Yeah. I mean...
So is that okay with you, or...?
It's only a matter of time.
Well, I don't know if it would be worth refusing. What if you can't fly unless you... submit, you know, the proof that you've had it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess the reason would be because it's so experimental. It's so it's so quick. It's so short. We don't know the effects yet.
Yeah, we kind of worried about that. So we're quite happy to wait and let the other people go forward. And, you know, by the time we get it, will probably be summer anyway. So, but even that short, we still don't know. It could be a year, 2 years down the road before we really find out. You know, the repercussions.
I don't even think they're forcing people to do the vaccine that's happening in a couple months, and that's happening right now.
Right, yeah, it's not mandatory.
You're a nurse or something. I don't think... Yeah.
Mandatory vaccines for nurses, you think would be okay?
Yeah.
But so if they didn't want to take it, they would lose their job?
Yeah, probably. Mm-hmm. Because they're working with other people.
Different people every day. Mm-hmm. You don't know if they have COVID or not.
Right.
And everything.
Yeah.
So yeah, I agree.
They're a medical professional.
Exactly.
So
medical profession.
I'm pretty sure it is mandatory for them.
I don't think for the vaccine at this point that it's mandatory. In fact, there are a lot of health people in the United States who are refusing to get the vaccine.
Well, that's because they're stupid. They're dumb.
Well, this vaccine's being rushed out. It's an experimental thing. It's happening. Whenever have they created one in such short little time? Are you willing to take the risk of an experimental vaccine like that?
I'm pretty sure there has been a lot of, like, thousands of volunteers who have...
And there's been thousands of people who have gotten sick from it and had allergic reactions, too.
Yeah, allergic reaction.
And this is for a virus with a 99.7 recovery rate. Right?
I think we should go.
But are you aware of that, though? The 99% recovery rate. It's people over the age of 70 who are dying.
Is this an anti-masker vote?
I'm not anti-mask. No. I'm not. I'm pro-choice.
Oh.
You know, I want people to be able to choose to be able to wear a mask or not. I don't want anybody to have to force a mask on me. That's a violation of my rights.
That's kind of fucking stupid.
What's that?
I have a health problem, so coming from a person who has a health condition, that's really fucking stupid.
What is?
Just that.
That is a violation of my rights to be forced to be...
It's just trying to get other people safe from it. It's
based on something that's comparable to the common influenza flu or the regular cold.
It's not common to me. Okay. The worst thing that could happen is that there's an inconvenience. If there was a mandatory, if the law was forcing you to wear a mask, the worst thing that could happen is that you are inconvenienced by a flimsy piece of fabric.
Oh, there's people who are getting sick from them. There's all sorts of different respiratory issues.
The best possible outcome is that you're preventing someone else from getting sick.
You know, the virus is a lot smaller than the holes in the mask. The holes in the mask are a certain size, and the virus is a lot smaller than that. So, you're done?
I couldn't care less about a lockdown. I'm going to do what I want to do. You can come to my house if you want, but, you know, arrest me, but that's it. Yeah.
Freedom's important.
It is. Freedom, yeah. I mean, I've traveled a lot of places on this world, 42 different countries. I can say that that's pretty much all you can ask for is freedom.
As a well-traveled guy, how do you feel about the fact that it's almost impossible to go anywhere without having to be forced into some sort of 14-day quarantine?
Yeah, that's, thank God for people like you, you know, because I don't see anybody else putting up any sort of fight. And, I don't think it's going to turn out well at all. It's been 10 months, 99.927% survival rate. It's bullshit.
Well, it doesn't make sense. Like, you know, they never had a vaccine for the cold or for some other illnesses like AIDS.
Yeah.
So how is there one now within a couple months? And what's inside this vaccine? What is inside it? How is that going to benefit me?
Yeah.
And what's really inside this? You know, what is it? I don't trust it.
And have you done a bit of research on your own or how is it that you've come to this kind of conclusion?
Yeah, I've been looking online.
You sound like you're not getting your information from the news, because the news
Absolutely
is just pumping fear on people.
Absolutely not. No, especially the CBC. Funded by our my dollars.
Yeah.
And it's absolute bullshit every single night.
All right, so that was pretty interesting, to say the least, I would say. I think it felt like there was more people on the side of being pro lockdown and mask than on the others, but I was still kind of surprised to see a certain maybe 40%, would you say, people who were like, yeah, no, this is not cool.
Definitely, yeah. Yeah, maybe it's just like one or two really hardcore, like, everything the government is doing is okay.
Right.
And then everybody else was either like, well, we're not so sure, or like the first one that we got, which was just straight up like,
yeah,
everything is wrong with the situation.
Yeah.
You know, in terms of the mandates. So yeah, it was a really good mix, I think. Actually.
Yeah, it's funny enough that kid that you saw, the kind of redhead kid, he was the first one that we got today, and he was like totally, totally awake.
And we can mention that we have had our share of technical difficulties today, no question.
Yeah.
That's why we're standing together, close together like this right now with just a GoPro.
Using my phone.
Yeah, everything that could go wrong, you know, kind of went wrong for us,
yeah,
but we made it work anyways.
Yeah.
And we were fortunate enough, I think, you found a lot of really good people right away. And then we tried to move around a bit. We had the protesters march through our interviews. Had that interesting guy who was talking about, like, I didn't even really understand at first what he was saying when he was talking about how he had COVID-19, but he's like, you know, it's the government is going to use this kind of against us.
Yeah.
And he had this really nuanced kind of understanding of everything, because he wasn't like very anti-government, but he was like still kind of like, the government is going to infringe on your rights as just a matter of course, you know. It was like really,
I was almost surprised nobody was a little more aggressive. Not that we're looking for that, obviously.
Yeah.
We toyed with the idea of doing a change my mind type thing with COVID's not that bad, change my mind, but we thought that might draw some too much negative attention. But I was suspecting some, but we didn't get it, thankfully.
Yeah.
People remained respectful and calm and courteous, so it was all good.
Yeah, and there does seem to be some, people are just kind of getting weary a little bit of the narrative.
Yeah.
It's kind of getting old, even for the people that I would say would probably a month or two ago be totally pro-government measures. Even they are kind of like, it's kind of like getting old. We're kind of bored of this now.
Yeah. 2 weeks to flatten the curve, turning into a year is
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it was great. It was great to be able to do this with you, Dan. I really appreciate you, you know, giving me the opportunity to work with you. I admire you. you know, I follow you. So, yeah, this has been really fun for me.
Well, it's a great event. Of course, William's from Got Dialogue, and this is why I wanted to team up with him today, because it's all about opening up that dialogue with people so we can have a better understanding moving forward. So, guys, if you like that, be sure to click the thumbs up button, share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to William on Got Dialogue on BitChute, bitchute.com/gotdialogue, and me as well at bitchute.com/pressfortruth. All the links are located in the description below. Thanks again for watching, guys. Stay tuned for more coming soon. This is Dan from Press for Truth and William from Got Dialogue. Peace. We all want truth. The truth will set you free.